Back in the day, I was really good at Wolfenstein 3D. I would burst into that room like a boss, and enemies would come running at me this direction and that direction. Pew, pew, pew. They were done. Now I'm free to wander around Castle Wolfenstein, pushing spacebar on every single wall looking for that treasure. Nowadays, though, my FPS skills are just no match for those bot masters. Did I get worse? No, that code got smarter. Welcome to CompChomp, the only show on the internet where we always set our bots to aggressive. In the beginning was the FPS NPC, and his code was pretty simple. If you detect the player, run directly at her, firing your weapon until either she's dead or you are. And that was pretty much it. The code was so simple that many a poor NPC actually ended up running face first into a wall. They weren't quite smart enough to realize that straight at the enemy wasn't going to work in every instance. In those early days, you could even get NPCs to fight each other. Doom was pretty famous for this. It was called Monster Infighting, and what you had to do is stand in exactly the right spot between two groups of monsters. And then you just kind of dodge a bullet so that this monster hits that monster, and you step back and watch the NPCs kill each other. Dummies. We have really high expectations of our modern day shooters, though. We expect the NPCs to strategically figure out what they need to do, to figure out how to get there on the map in order to do it, and, most importantly, we do not want to see them smacking into walls on their way to do this. It's asking for a lot. In the late 90s, Valve gifted us with a game that brought FPS AI into the modern era, Half-Life. We follow the harrowing tale of Dr. Gordon Freeman as he tries to save the planet from an experiment gone horribly, horribly wrong. And compared to some of those early wall-humping monsters, the NPCs in Half-Life, they looked like PhD candidates. Valve achieved this using a combination of finite-state machines, decision trees, and fuzzy logic. With finite-state machines, each NPC has a fixed number of states that they can be in. For instance, a basic NPC might have the following states: patrol for an enemy, shoot at an enemy, look for health, die. Aw, poor NPC. Sorry about that last one. Each state comes along with a basic set of behaviors that an NPC engages in when it's in that state, and each NPC is only allowed to be in one state at a time. There's no dying and patrolling for players. This isn't Left 4 Dead. Decision trees are the way that an AI figures out which state it should actually be in. Let's say I'm an innocent little headcrab just minding my own business when Dr. Freeman goes strolling by. Well, now I need to know, did I see him? And if the answer is no, I get to mind my own business. But if the answer is yes, I need more information. For instance, is he near or far? If he's far away, I have to start crawling toward him all head crabby. But if he's near, I get to leap forward and feast on those delightful brains. The final piece, the one that ties everything together, is logic. And game devs, we like our logic the same way we like our adorable little animals. Fuzzy! With traditional Boolean logic, something can either be true or false, either a 0 or a 1. Either you're close enough for the Combine soldier to shoot, or you're not. And that can actually lead to some strange behavior. Say you're like right on that boundary zone. Now you see me. Oh, now you don't. Now you see me. Now you don't. And the soldier's like, what? That's not the way that Valve wanted this game to work. They wanted it to seem more natural. So they used fuzzy logic. In a fuzzy logic system, you get to have ranges. No more near or far. You can have multiple truth values, and you get to be a member of more than one truth value at a time. You can be 0.2 near, 0.8 medium, and 0 far. Apply some magic defuzzification math, and boom. It turns out you're just close enough for that Combine soldier to keep shooting at you. And it's those gradual transitions between states that actually allow the AI to seem a whole lot more human. And that is how Valve created the greatest game of all time! In fact, there are a whole lot of people that argue that the AI in Half-Life, the original Half-Life even, was way more advanced than some of the more modern released games. And that's because Valve had one more secret. Half-Life was a very story-driven, almost linear game, so the devs were able to guide you in through one path and make sure that the number of interactions that you could have with the NPCs were very limited. When you limit how a player can interact with an NPC, it's a whole lot easier to make those interactions seem human. And the advanced players at the time? Oh, those guys realized it. They didn't want some scripted, half-assed AI interactions. They wanted true artificial intelligence in their games. But what could that mean? Oh, perhaps it means a new video. CompChomp.